Ratnakar Matkari is a renowned Marathi writer. He has enthralled entire generation of Maharashtra through his creative writing. He is a popular writer, author, director, film producer, playwright, scriptwriter, and self-learned painter. Born in 1938 in Mumbai, Ratnakar Matkari was very creative and enthusiastic in his childhood. After graduation in economics in 1958, he worked in a bank for some time. And then he devoted his career to writing, direction, and production. He has written many Marathi stage dramas, one-act plays, short stories, novels, and child plays. He has authored various books. In 70s, he also worked as a columnist for popular newspapers and magazines. Let's go back and walk down the memory lane with Ratnakar Matkari and find out how he started his creative journey.
Namaskar.
Namaskar.
Ratnakar ji, as we know, you've been writing for last so many decades. But when did writing begin in your life? Did you decide at some point that okay, I'm going to be a writer, or it came naturally? How did the process of a writer begin?
Till I didn't decide to become a writer.
Okay.
I became one automatically. In fact, I started writing as a kid in school. But I was not aware that I could write. I thought everyone who's a little good in subjects like literature, Marathi, vagara, vagara, he can write. That's what I presumed. At that time, I thought that painting is something that has to be learned. Okay. And writing comes automatically to one.
So how did painting happen?
Just like writing happened, I couldn't take painting that seriously as I did writing in later years.
Okay.
I was inclined to do some painting. I was good at anatomy. Proportions and whatnot, and whatever is needed for basic painting. But then writing came to me suddenly, when actually it came to me through theater, because when I was a kid, I read a lot of plays. I was interested in plays, and I used to ask about them to my father. He used to give me a lot of information about how plays were staged then and whatnot. So somehow the theater was in me, which made me write. Because when I was in very first year, when I was about 16, 17 then, I wrote a one-act play. Okay. And since I didn't know what to do about it, I just gave it to All India Radio, where I was participating in a couple of plays, in Sanskrit plays that too.
Okay.
So I gave them and they liked them, and they started broadcasting. And at that time, All India Radio was a very major thing. I mean, people didn't have anything else to listen to. So I became immediately established as a writer.
Moreover, started with intercollegiate or as a writer to in one act plays, which mostly is done in intercollegiate. So tell us something about those.
Remember that that was a period of renaissance in Marathi literature and art. In 50s, everybody was thinking anew, and everywhere there were new groups. So in Bharati Vidya Bhavan also there was a group like Damu Kenkare, Vijaya, Jaivant at that time. And Anand Pai, Nandakumar Raute, so these people, they had a competition, and so many good writers participated in it. and my play came second. So competition was not important. It was important to discover good writers and it was a new theater movement. New actors were discovered, new directors were discovered. So luckily I was in the midst of it.
Ratnakar Matkari established Bal Natya Sabha, which is known as a children's theater group, producing imaginative plays for children. This group also decided to perform these child plays for those children who are not capable of visiting theater, like children in schools, rural areas, slums, and for street children. He has performed as an actor in most of the children dramas of Bal Natya Sabha.
I had my own group, children's theatre group, Bal Natya, where I had my own concepts to follow, which I couldn't ask any other director to. In fact, I had visualized the kind of theatre that I wanted to. I had known something about theatre, about direction also, because in college, I was in Elphinstone College, where Mr. Alkazi used to come and mount plays. I had seen it as a stranger. Then I observed Vijaya Mehta, who was again associated with Alkazi.
Right.
So the whole system I had absorbed in me. Not only direction, the whole concept of theater, which was very elastic, very mobile, very free kind of theater, which he taught us in the college. I mean, we converted anything into everything.
How come children's? You were doing one act plays. You were doing adults plays. Normally people who do one act, you're dealing with a youth, then you move on to adults for purely commercial. How come Bal Natya? How come you came back to children?
Actually, it started with Sudha Karmarkar, who did my Madhuvanjari for Sahitya Sangha. I wrote it for her.
Okay.
And then I was part of it. Without knowing that I was so much interested in children's literature. Because and children's theater, children's film.
Natak karna, me natak karna. Natak karna, me natak karna. Natak karna, me natak karna. Shri Ganesha la vandan karun. कॉम्प्युटर आला सलाम करून नाटक करणार मी नाटक करणारोरांसाठी थोरांसाठी बाळांसाठी आई बाबांसाठी पोरांसाठी थोरांसाठी बाळांसाठी बाबांसाठी चौथी मधल्या कार्ट्यांसाठी चौथी मधल्या कार्ट्यांसाठी
चौथी मधल्या कार्ट्यांसाठी
अंसाठी तरल्या आजांसाठी
अंसाठी तरल्या आजांसाठी
आत्या मावश्या काकांसाठी आणि काका मामे भाकांसाठी नाटक करणार मी नाटक करणार.
Children's theater has to be very open, has to be very free.
Yeah.
And in fact, it was not only children's theater. It was my concept of theater that I was working on through children's theater. So that's why I said, I don't look at it as plays made for children. I think it's a branch of theater itself.
You know, most of your plays, we see that there is a lot of comedy. There's a streak of humor all the time. But humor for children is far different from humor for adults.
That's why my adult plays are not very different from my children's plays, and my children's plays are based on the same values, same theater values as adult plays, because it is part of theater. Rather, I kept on experimenting in my children's theater, and I thought that it was my laboratory.
Children's plays a lot, all of them I love. Jaise Albata Galbata hai. Albata Galbata was a fantastic play. Or audience participation jo hoti thi. उसमें जो उनके प्ले में मैंने देखी वो मैंने किसी भी एडल्ट या चिल्ड्रंस प्ले में बाकी नहीं देखी, कि बच्चे जैसे चिल्ला के खड़े रहते थे थिएटर में, इतने इंग्रॉस्ड रहते थे, इतनी इंग्रॉस्ड ऑडियंस मैंने किसी भी प्ले में नहीं देखी उनकी प्लेस को छोड़ के। बहुत उनको हर एक चीज़ पता होती है और ऐसा उन्हें चाहिए कि हर एक एक्टर को सब जो भी उन्होंने सिखाया हो वो उसने फौरन पिकअप किया है और वो कर रहा है, और यहाँ वहाँ घूम रहे हो अटेंशन नहीं दे रहे हो तो वो उन्हें ज़रा भी पसंद नहीं है। तो वो काफ़ी मेरे साथ भी उन्होंने जैसे ही किया, ऐसे नहीं कि लड़की है बच्ची है अपनी तो कैसे भी बिहेव करे। एक मुझे इंसिडेंस याद है, मैं जब छोटी थी एक मुझे बड़ी औरत का रोल दिया था द ग्रेट गोल्डन गैंग नाम की प्ले में, तो मुझे वो अच्छा नहीं लगता था बिकॉज आई वॉज वेरी यंग, 10-15 साल की थी, तो मैं तैयारी नहीं थी तो मैं कुछ भी करके टाल जाती थी, कहीं भाग जाती थी। तो एक दिन उन्होंने कहा यहाँ आ जाओ, अभी फ़ौरन स्टार साड़ी पहनो। मैं मैक्सी पहन के घूम रही थी, उन्होंने कहा नहीं अभी कहीं से भी लेके आओ एक साड़ी और अभी वो सीन तुम्हें करना है और मैं जिस तरह से बोल रहा हूँ वैसे ही। एंड देन आई डिड द सीन एंड आई स्टार्टेड एंजॉयिंग इट। मैंने सोचा कि अरे ये सही कह रहे थे, ये हम कर सकते हैं। और बड़ी लड़की की माँ का रोल भी वो इट वॉज हिलेरियस कॉमेडी टाइप ऑफ सीन, इट वॉज फैंटास्टिक एंड आई स्टार्टेड एंजॉयिंग इट।
जो भी कुछ वो बोलते हैं उसके पीछे एक विचारधारा होती है, उनको बहुत कुछ कहने का होता है लेकिन उसमें कुछ सब्सटेंस होता है, इसलिए उनके साथ गप्पे मारना बहुत ही एक क्या बोलते हैं आनंददायी ऐसी बात है। और एक है उनको टेरिफिक सेंस ऑफ ह्यूमर है, तो उनकी बातें बहुत ही मज़ेदार और व्यंगपूर्ण होती है, इसलिए उनके साथ बातें करना मुझे तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है, कुछ तो मुझे सीखना मिलता है।
He has a remarkable talent, maybe because of his competence with words, his interest in painting, and his interest in music. All these have combined into making him a very fine director.
रत्नाकर जी बहुत अच्छे गाने लिखते हैं बच्चों के लिए। जैक एंड द बीनस्टॉक में गाए हैं, आपको मालूम ही होगा। तो वो गाए थे एक गाना था, इतना अच्छा था, एक जो उसमें एक राक्षस होता है उसको सब बच्चे मारते हैं बांधते हैं, तो उसके लिए एक गाना था। और फिर वो गाना गाते हैं, जय जय बोला राक्षस हरला, जय जय बोला राक्षस हरला, जयंगो राक्षस हरला हरला, जयंगो राक्षस हरला।
Many of his plays he directed himself, adult plays, children's plays, experimental plays and professional plays.
Where does the experiment start? It is the sharing of confidence between yourself and the audience. You have to be very, very honest in writing as well as in theater. You have to say that this is what I am going to do, this is what I am about to do. You have to take the audience into confidence. Then I wrote so many plays where the stage manager comes, where the narrator comes and tells the audience that this is the thing. In my first play, Nimashima Rachas, which we did for our own group, Ballet, the stage manager comes and says, well, we have nothing like a set here. I'm trying to accumulate everything and then we'll see how the play goes on. So the
and you pick a girl from the audience also and do the play.
That was in Rakshas
Ratindava.
But the audience used to like it so much. They became an integral part of it.
काय मेले आधु झाले डोळे, एक अक्षर दिसेल तर शपथ, त्यातून काळोखा असा दाट, म्हणा मला मेलीला काळोखात नीट दिसलं नाही तर जळलं चेटकी असून फायदा तो काय। आता जादून थोडा उजेड पाडावा, काय बर तो उजेडाचा मंत्र, हा राती भूतांच्या हाती काळे कुट्ट घडे नि काळोखाचा आड, राहूचा राग तुला लागेल डाग, मेल्या चंद्रा थोडा तरी उजेड पाड, उजेड उजेड उजेड।
Every play has a value, has a moral, has a message that is sent out. And your plays, especially children's plays, are not only for children. Like Makda Makda Hoop or Chamatkar Zalas Paije or Dhadpade Badbade Markute Ani Mandali. All these plays have been chotya motyans or chotya motyans saathi. Matlab, bachcho ka aur bado ka और बच्चों और बड़ों के लिए ये जो कॉन्सेप्ट है, सो टेल अस समथिंग अबाउट दैट एज वेल.
Whenever we talk about children's plays, we say children of all ages. That is from 5 to 80. Not that we exclude people after 80. But anyway, the point is, those who can enjoy that kind of freedom, those who can look at theater with that kind of uninhibited mind, they can enjoy. And again, I say the values for children are the same as they are for adults.
पानी वाले, पानी है का तुमच्या पाशी?
है की भरपूर है, ये पीप नहीं दिसत, भरलेला है ते पाण्यान, राजाच्या मालकीच्या खास तऱ्याच्या पाण्यान.
खरं सांगताय, मग मला चार थेंब पाणी द्या, घशाला पुरट पडली आहे. आभाळा ढग नाही का, झाडाची सावली नाही, चार थेंब द्या, उपकार होतील.
बडबड बंद कर, पैसे काढ, एका लोटीला दोन मोहरा.
दोन मोहरा? मी कुठून आणू दोन मोहरा? मी एक गरीब शेतकरी, नदीचं पाणी होत तेव्हा शेती करायचा. लोटीभर पाणी मला नाही परवडणार, तसेच दोन थेंब दे.
He has been a success in all the forms, but I think I should refer to the fact that he started writing different kinds of plays with different approaches, social, psychological, theatrical. He wrote one-act plays, he wrote comedies in the initial phase, which were very different. I mean, his Aranyak and Ashwamedh and Lokakatha Theatre, Prema Kahani is one of his earlier experimental plays, but all these others were Ghar Tighan Zahava. They were successful on the professional stage.
आरण्यक जो है वो blank verse में है, कविता की तरह है पूरा, जो लिखना बहुत मुश्किल है किसी को भी, और आज भी कोई पढ़े तो सुकून मिलता है काफी पढ़ के.
I don't look at it as plays made for children. I think it's a branch of theater itself. Even Lokakatha Theatre, it is one of my most successful, most talked about plays, most translated in other languages play. But that also, simultaneously, I was thinking of a theater which is like happening. I wanted to give the audience the experience of something happening before their eyes. So I was just thinking how I could achieve that.
Ratnakar Madkari is a painter and a great designer. Social issues raised by during Narmada Bachao Andolan in 1989 appealed so much to Ratnakar ji that he decided to translate his ideas into paintings.
Incidentally, you are also into a social approach. You have dealt with problems which are about social cause. So could you tell us something about Narmada Bachao Andolan? So you've done your contribution there as well. So what about?
Actually, okay. When I visited Manibeli, visited Narmada Andolan, people talked to Medha Patkar, attended their lectures and whatnot, whatever was necessary. I still couldn't conceive a play. Just as I told you, I knew the problem, I knew the people, I knew the characters, but it didn't occur to me as a theater project. Actually, this painting is based on a true story, which shows that the people in the valley had become so bold that a young girl didn't let the police enter into her hut and decided not to move out of her hut. I'd visited Manibeli and seen the plight of the valley dwellers. Actually, there were many atrocities happening to the valley dwellers, like there was one murder. I saw a body which was hanging there for 3 days, so only the remnants were there, and the whole thing, which was supposed to be a clean ground. Then there is an intelligentsia who were quite cozily settled in their own ivory towers, who were busy having their parties, having their newspapers, and generally be happy in their cool, quiet, in their own circumstances, safely ignoring what was happening in the valley. A picture about Medha's leadership, which I thought was fascinating against all odds. Now the world knows a lot about it, and she's given the Right Livelihood Award also. But at that time, she was suffering a lot due to the police force, but that was not sufficient. We know what happened to the Narmadana Andolan. We think that city people don't have to look into the matters of the Narmada Valley. But ultimately, it is the urban crowd that's going to suffer, because the persons who will be replaced, persons who will be have to leave their villages, will ultimately come in the city streets and turn into beggars.
When you get a concept in your mind, how do you decide whether it should be a painting or it should be in a written form?
In fact, I feel bad that I always think of writing and never of painting.
Writing किसी भी तरह का उनको भाता है, मतलब एक ही नहीं, जो फॉर्म जब वो लिखते हैं वो उतने ही मन, मतलब जितने बच्चों का लिखते हैं उतना वो स्ट्रेंज स्टोरीज का लिखते हैं, जितना वो ललित लेखन करते हैं जैसे कॉलम्स लिखते हैं वगैरह, तो हर एक काम में उनका उतना ही मन होता है, उसके सिवा वो लिख ही नहीं सकते.
और पेंटिंग,
इसी पेंटिंग का उनका मतलब, मैं जिम्मेदार हूँ कि मैंने कहा कि अब राइटिंग के लिए ज़्यादा ध्यान देना ज़रूरी है, ऐसे लगता है. तो अगर सोचना है तो अभी सोचो, और तब उन्होंने डिसीजन लिया कि पेंटिंग मैं अभी के लिए छोड़ देता हूँ. अभी उन्होंने फिर शुरू किया, लेकिन वो उनको बहुत दुख है कि तब छोड़ना पड़ा, और मैं भी उसके लिए जिम्मेदार हूँ.
Designed the cover page of his own books, and he also designed the cover page and drawings of many other children's books of poetry written by a well-known writer, Gyanpeeth awardee Vinda Karandikar ji. His line drawings are very imaginative, effective and colorful. Ratnakar Matkari received various awards and prizes. Dada Sahab Phalke Award for the script of the film Majha Ghar Majha Sansar in 1987, Gangadhar Gadgil Sahitya Award in 1997, Gadkari Award for topmost drama writer in 2002, Sangeet Natak Academy Award in 2003, Manupatra of Natya Mahotsav in 2004, Five Foundation Award in 2005, and Marathi Sahitya Award in 2006. Ratnakar Matkari is a true legend who can be a role model for younger generation. He is a great writer, painter, playwright, scriptwriter, producer, director, designer, and author. He started his creative pursuit at the age of 16 years, and still his creative journey is going on.
Zarahalu. चला पुढे, नका करू मुळी हू की चू 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 चू. हे आसन इंद्राचे, बसायचे बसायचे
हे मन असं नाही इंद्राचे बसायचे बसायचे तुम आम्हाला कवडी मोलाचे.